Hello everyone, I am Ritik Kumar Jain, is going to present a presentation on polygraph. Polygraph is a machine which measures human responses to a series of questions, and the responses of physiological measures are blood pressure, pulse responses and skill conductivity, while the subject is asked to answer the series of questions in the question of formation of yes or no. The brief interpreting of the uses of the polygraph is to detect the answer which while the produces a physiological response and the different form of association and not depicting the answers. Which means that there will be a series of a question or of 5 to 6 depending on the cases, and there will be subject which has to answer the answers in the form of yes or no. While the giving the answer, there will be 4 to 6 physiological differences and the depiction which will be measured by the polygraph. Now, the polygraph was discovered by John Augustus Larson, which worked for basically two polygraph formation like sphygmomanometers and galvanic skin responses. Later on in 1930s around, Leonardo Kleiner joined and co-invented the polygraph machine, which he detected by using mnemograph and polygraph only, like polygraph chart. It works. How does it work? The polygraph machine technically measures 4 to 6 responses attached to the patient body. The sensory are usually recorded as breathing rate, which measures our lungs and diaphragm movements. Pulse, which can be measured by the hand movements and the pulse. Blood pressure by the cuff and the sphygmomanometer, and perspiration, which will be measured by the galvanic skin responses. Perspiration is the sweating and unusual body movements of a patient. Instruments used in the machine are sphygmomanometers, mnemograph and galvanic skin responses. Sphygmomanometer, we all know at, we are knowing all this. It measures the blood pressure and it is tied on the right arm of a patient and measures the graphical representation of the sphygmomanometer, blood pressure it measures. And mnemograph is a device used to measure the lung expansion and the diaphragm movements. So as we breathe, our lungs expand and diaphragm moves up and down, so in the abdominal cavity. So it measures and show the graphical representation of that. Galvanic skin responses, it contains two copper plates attached to the fingerprints of the person. As we sweat or as we are somatic nervous system moves or create any impulses, we start to sweat. So copper conducts the electricity and present in the graphical formation. Now I will show you how this works. Polygraph works the lie detector. So as we know that there are the four responses, it measure body movements, breathing rates, respiration, pulse movements. So firstly we will record the blood pressure and the recording the blood pressure. We use sphygmomanometer, which is shown in the first part. Secondly, the rubber tubes placed on the chest and the abdominal cavity of the breathing, which measures the lungs movement. Second and the third, diaphragm movement, and the third, the two metallic plates attached to the fingerprints for recording the sweating, which is the third point. And the all the representation and the goes to the graphical, which is shown here. Now procedure of working. In legal system, the procedure of conducting the polygraph is on the divided on the basis of three steps. First, pre-test interview, formation of questionnaire, and post-test interview. In pre-test interview, the psychologist asks the person to share his feelings or any questions, like normal questions like what is your name, where do you belong to. So it lowers the sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system of the person and creates a rapport and a trust building of the person. Secondly, the psychologist or the polygraph expert collect the case history from the other person, which will ensure the formation of the questionnaire. Information is given to the patient and in the form of signature or the application or the note is given to the person. So in the legal system it will help. Introduction about the instruments is also given. We will explain the person what the information we are going to give to the person or what type of instruments are going to be there. And firstly, we will check the questionnaire language. If a person is from the different language and we conduct a test in the different language, then the validity of the test will not be there. on the basis of case study which we collected, there is the formation of questionnaire. The questionnaire is contained and collected and created on the basis of case history. Depending on the case history, there will be 10 to 20 questionnaires. Then when the test starts, we repeat the questionnaire 3 times in unjumbled form. And the last, when the test is conducted, we take a signature on the graph, knowing that the person has given the polygraph on the basis of his own consent only. And if there is a variation in the graph, then we will ask for the variation to explain the person if there is a variation. Sure. Now, type of graph and the questionnaire usually conducted. Questionnaire contains 3 types of questions: relevant question, control question, and irrelevant question. Relevant questions are the questions which are related directly to the case, not to anyone, like unlessly. Like if a person has committed a crime, so the psychologists or experts will ask the question that, did you committed the crime or not, or do you know the person or not? So that is relevant question. Control questions are like, there is only thin layer between the relevant and irrelevant ke beech mein jo line aati hai, wo control question ki hoti hai. It comprises of indirectly question, like if a murder is conducted in a place called Indore, so the person will ask like, do you know this city, or do you have been going to a visit at this city? Or irrelevant questions are unrelated or unlinked to the questions, like name of a person or job occupation, etc. And in the legal system, there are 2 articles which are violated by the constitution by the polygraph. The article 21 of Constitution of India, we state that the no person shall be deprived his or his personal life or his personal liberty. Like, we have no rights to conduct any information or any process to interfere in this personal liberty. Secondly, Constitution rights, Article 20, Subclause 3, which does not allow a person to commit any offence or any evidence towards himself. Like, we cannot force a person to give an application or any statement against himself committing any crime. Thank you, and do like my video. Hope this polygraph video will help you.